Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And I was thinking, with what kind of vehicle do I want to play today? And I thought, why not to play with a classical 268? I have a question. Do you remember, fellas, when this vehicle used to be like real ninja? Back in the day when Swamp Map was still there, back in the day when this vehicle had 850 alpha damage and so on, so on. If I'm not mistaken, it used to be one of the most, if not the most powerful tank destroyer. It used to be good because back in the day, I think E3 got nerfed, E4 got nerfed, and the 268 had humongous camo values. Currently, this vehicle is having 36. Back in the day, if I'm not mistaken, this vehicle had like 45, if not 50. So why not to give it a go, and why not to play with this vehicle once or twice to check out how this tank is performing nowadays, right? This is quite interesting stuff, and I must admit I am quite excited about this. Before everything, I am curious, can we make gun handling a bit better of this vehicle? Let's see, can we make a gun handling a bit better? Not really. You know what? I'm going to do the most idiotic thing ever. Skill, what kind of most idiotic thing? Actually, never mind. Later on, we will switch equipment a bit. Anyways, let's go into the battle and let's see what this vehicle is all about. I am thinking about putting the aiming thingy, right, which is making the accuracy a bit better because it is important thing, right? And one more thing which I want to highlight about this vehicle, if you would pay attention at the high explosive penetration and high explosive ammunition overall, you can see it has 1100 alpha damage and 90 millimeters of penetration, which can be truly humongous, especially when someone is making mistake. In fact, let's start our battle with one high explosive shot. Maybe we are going to be lucky enough to find the EBR Ferrari, which is going through the middle of the field, and then we will schnai him in the face for 1000, right? Why the heck not to try it? I don't really think we can lose something, right? At least that's what I want to believe. And obviously, I care about your opinion about this tank destroyer, fellas. What do you think about it? This is information not only for me, but for people which might think about getting this vehicle for themselves, right? So this could be very, very, very beneficial. So if you could share your information, I would appreciate that. Or I supposed to say, if you could share your opinion about this tank destroyer, right? By the way, if you are wondering what I'm doing here, I'm knocking those trees all the time, so people which is playing here is not going to be able to outspot us. That's very, 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 very important thing. Speaking about the gun depression of this vehicle, it's a bit depressing, right? You can't see shit, unfortunately. But that's okay. Let it be. Relax, take it easy, and simply let's wait until someone is going to make one or another mistake. Usually, fellas, speaking about the light tanks and about medium tanks, in this line of the bushes, there is plenty of them, right? So keep this in mind. Keep this in mind, fellas. And so far, no shots whatsoever. E50M was somewhere here. So there is a bit of a chance, I believe, enemies left this side unprotected. But in the same time, unfortunately, I'm not brave enough to go in front to check the things out, right? I don't really think it's truly worth it. Meanwhile, I'm trying to go for a blind shot right here. Maybe we are going to hit someone, or maybe not. And as you can see, we are not hitting anyone, but we are not getting spotted. Meanwhile, what that means we could make a bit of pressure here, and I changed my mind. Oh boy, I changed my mind. Oh, I changed my mind, fellas. Okay, let's see. CS-63 is moving sideways like this, and I'm thinking about punishing this mother trucker for 800 in the face. And luckily, fellas, we managed to do that. Great. Very, very, very good. Now the question is, can we find another shot for this mother trucker? Because STB is going to be able to deal with him, and it is a fact, but the question is, maybe we can yoink the kill. And I was thinking maybe, fellas. I was thinking maybe, but I think it's not the case. It's okay. Relax, take it easy, we have this. We have this, fellas. And what do we have here? We have Mr. Mouse, which is showing his side for us. But unfortunately, 268 has the mind of his own. And unfortunately, we do not manage to punish him. But that's okay, fellas. That's completely fine. Relax. Take it easy. We got this. We got this. Nice. This is a nice penetration to the side of the Mr. Mouse. And one more thing, definitely worth highlighting. This tank have humongous standard penetration. By saying humongous, it is only 303 mm of penetration only. Combining with the Ruski gun, yeah, that's quite interesting, right? Speaking about the gold, pretty much for just a bit shy of 400 penetration. Woo! Boys, woo! That's interesting, right? Anyways, what kind of situation we have in this battle? Unfortunately, but enemy team have no team. Which is sad thing, but in the same time, what can you do about this? You can roll the Chinese tank for 885 in the face. How about that, fellas? How about that? Crazy stuff. I mean, when this gun is actually working, this is simply crazy stuff, my lovely friends. When this gun is actually working, this is not even funny how good it is looking like. Anyways, I truly want to punish this E50M here because he's like a free meatball and I truly want to get a 700 of the free meat. Aiming, here you go, 813. I mean, look at those high rolls, fellas. Look at those high rolls, my friends. 800 HP, still going through the open field, still saying I will F you up for that light tank, and we are saying no you won't. Meanwhile, he's down to 64 HP, so pretty much he's down to fartable, and now what we want to do, jump. Actually, I don't really think I'm going to reach this guy in time, but still, considering what kind of map we had, and with a score which we have, which is 15-3 simulator, right, I would say this is very, very, very good thing, right? Meanwhile, our 432 saying object version 4 is better, fellas, grind that one instead. Fellas, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, I think you should you should make your own reviews, right? I'm not saying this tank is better than Bobject by any means, but what is my main point? My main point is to watch back in time in a way, right? And to show you this vehicle can be playable. And fellas, top by the damage, fifth by experience. Everything is completely fine, very, very nice. Let's go for another battle. And after this, fellas, after this, high explosives. Okay, look, this might seem stupid, but you know what? I'm not the smartest creature in the forest anyway, so we are going to load here, and we are going to go to play against the medium tanks. If it will work, we will have a lot of shits and giggles, and that's the main plan of all this, so let's do this. Playing in the field. Let's talk about penetratable units. Batshit, Char Futur, Leo, Borat, Progetto, Wafflecock, even Esterva, Gusor. I mean, there is plenty of the tanks which we can actually penetrate, right? So that's the main point of us going into the mini city or town or village or however you are calling this, right? And hopefully we can penetrate someone who don't have armor. I truly want to see 1100 penetration, fellas. And I don't really think I'm asking too much, or am I? Or am I, fellas? E4, fellas. Oh, yeah. 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 Yes. Yeah. Not what I want. Unfortunately, not what I want, and I missed the budget here. That's quite unfortunate. Oh well, what can you do, cry every time. Anyways, the main battle is going to be here, so relax, take it easy, we got this, fellas. We definitely got this. Now Bachit is trying to escape like this, and he's doing that successfully, and Borat have no bloody clue in what kind of shithole he is, fellas. And Borat have no bloody clue in what kind of shithole he is. This guy knocked the tree in such a disgusting position, it's insane. And he is bigger pain in the ass than he is friend for us, but that's okay. Let it be. So right here, this tree you can use as a protection against people here or against people here. Unfortunately, if you are knocking down the tree like this, then it's not very, very good and it's completely wasted. But it's okay, let it be. We still have high explosive ammunition. I believe you know that, I know that too. So all we need to do, we need to be very, very, very patient until someone is going to get spotted, right? And eventually, fellas, eventually Progetto and Charfutur is going to say, And this is exactly what I'm looking for, and this is exactly what I'm waiting for. Meanwhile, E75 said I'm going to cross like this, so we punished him for 350. Obviously, if we would have the standard ammunition, it would be so much better, but it is how it is. 2 seconds left, I'm going for 750. But the funniest thing is he doesn't have the repair crew, so this is very, very, very good thing for us, right? This is very good thing for us. And now Leo. Mr. Leo, 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 yes, Leo, go like this. And now I'm kind of sad I do not have high explosives, so we are smacking him only for 600, which is not very, very good thing, but it is how it is. Let it be. Progetto is sitting in the deep shithole, fellas. You might think Progetto is fine, but reality is Russia. Reality is a bit different. Reality, Progetto is sitting in very, very bad situation because soon those guys will die, and whenever those guys will be dead, then the real fun is going to start for us in a way, right? So, once again, patience. That's quite sad, fellas, because this map is definitely not the most horrible map for this vehicle, but probably the biggest mistake which I did here is I decided to go kind of ham with high explosives, and it is not that great, unfortunately. I did not manage to punish anyone yet, and so on, and that's the worst thing for us, but that's okay. What do we want to do now? Now, fellas, we want to take this position here and we want to start banging the E100 or the E75, which is playing in the city here. Love crossing, crossing Russia. You think you can escape from Russia gun, Mr. Love? Come on. Come on, show some respect, mother trucker. Beautiful. Very, very beautiful. Now the question is, fellas, how to find the angle for this Progetto? This is very, very important thing. Aha, Progetto is thinking about peeking like this. That's good. And you know what? E100 just took one for the team. 700 for the team, fellas. That's beautiful. Now he shit his pants, which we can expect because whenever you are taking one third one quarter of your HP after one shot, you know, you're not feeling too great, don't you think so? So once again, we are waiting, we are sneaky mosquitoes right there, fellas. All we need to do, we need to wait until 50 TP will make pressure after. Progetto will try to do something silly, and it's very, very possible. And it's very, very possible the things will go in this way. Although one more thing which is definitely worth to highlight, this vehicle itself, it is a sniper schnitzel, right? You are not supposed to go in front and to show who is the most powerful cookie on the field, right? Because this tank is not created for that. Sure thing you can relocate, sure thing you can try to play against the lower tier shitters, right? Everything is completely fine, but in the same time, it's not... the first thing in the recommendation list how to play with this vehicle, it would be to go in front and to show who is the boss out there, right? Because it's just not the case. Anyways, how about if we would try to play here? Dede Fede got completely destroyed while I was sleeping, but that's okay. And you know what? I have an idea, fellas. Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, I have an idea. I truly want to figure out where Gisoris and where the Esterva is. So I'm crossing like this, which is very good thing. And now let's see, am I getting spotted here? The answer is no, I am not. Good information for us. How about if we would try to take this bush here? And how about if we will try to find a good angle to punish this E4, which might sit in this balcony right there. Right there, right? What do you think is the chance sitting right there, fellas? I don't really like the angle, unfortunately. I do not really like the angle. Okay, how about this if we are going to be more sneaky? Step by step, little by little, going a bit more aggressive here. Beautiful. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Russia. I love Russia. Beautiful. I'm spotted here, but I don't really care about this because I am getting myself quite a bit of assisting damage, and he is anyways dead, right? So that's definitely what we wanted. And now all we need to do, we need to start making pressure towards the Gasor or enemy Wafflecock or enemy 50 TP, doesn't really matter. Those guys are dead already. The most interesting thing for me is how many HP Wafflecock has. It's not worth to load high explosive. Shame. Well, you know, with high explosives it can be hit or miss. Sometimes you are punishing someone with for pretty much majority of their HP, and sometimes you are having a bad traits, and not much what you can do about this. Meanwhile, we are going like this. This guy is dead. That's fine, and hopefully we are going to have a nice angle for this Wafflecock, right? Although it's still quite questionable, because wait, 5, 4, 3, 2, I should have went for this. It's okay. Look, once again, quite good game. I definitely can't complain. 4,100 damage, 500 assisting damage. Can we cry about this, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen? Can we cry about this? I don't really think so. Good, very good. And now, you know what is the plan C, I suppose to say? One battle with a bit of the different setup for ourselves. I am thinking about making this tank the most accurate dog on the field, if we can say so. Anyways, we are second by the damage. That's very good. I'm very happy. And we are top 7 by experience. But once again, not a big surprise considering we did majority of our damage via the huge range, right? So we can't complain about this. So, what I wanted to change, optics for aiming device. This is the device which I recommend using on majority of the tank destroyers, because it's making your accuracy better. If you would pay attention, fellas, we pretty much gained 0.02 dispersion, which is very good thing if you would ask me. Although now the view range which we have is 430 1 meter, so it's a bit, you know, we became in a way a glass cannon when we can't see shit, right? We can smack someone quite accurately. So let's see, is it going to work or not? And what do we have here? We have a very interesting battle, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. With a tank destroyer, I don't really like the cliff, but we will try to make it work. I don't really like cliff, but we will make it work. If you are wondering what is happening in this pigeon head, I am thinking about pretty much sniping from the red line. But skill, I'm telling you, sniping from the red line. This is exactly what I am thinking about. Look, I think we could support our guys, which is going and playing there quite well. What is my priority? My priority is obviously to knock this tree down, so in a way it's going to behave like a cover for us, right? And we are waiting until someone will start flanking like this, or alternatively until someone will try to play here hold down. It is extremely good angle. I know it sounds idiot proof and it looks like idiot proof, right? But believe me, fellas, it's not the case. Bless me. Don't say anything, okay? It happens. I have allergy from the Ferraris. What can I say, fellas? I have allergy from Ferraris. So, what is the best angles which you can get with this from this side? You can take the angle. You can have angle against the MX-30, right? You can have angle right there, and you can have angle right there. So wherever you are going to look at, you can actually punish the enemy forces without bigger problems whatsoever, and that's great. Honestly, this is the position which I figured out recently. Because you know me, I don't really like to snipe from the bloody base and to chill there, right? But in the same time, if it is working, why to try to research other bicycle, right? If that makes sense. This position is golden, this position is epic, so why to think about something else, right? When it's clearly working, right? Good. Wait. We have all time in the world of tanks. And as you can see, our... Please, RNG, let me hit this tank. Oop, unfortunately, that wasn't the hit. As you can see, Fave is saying... Fave is saying, ooh, you have a shot, Smother Truckers. Can I join the party? Can I join the party? Can I join the party? Probably that's what he is thinking, right? And you know what? We are inviting him here. And let's see. Can we punish someone here? Phase 1 is not very, very happy. He's thinking, you bloody base bunkers, sniper schnitzels, useless mother truckers. That's what he is thinking. And you know what? When we have our start, we have 1,500 damage. We can start making pressure somewhere else, right? I am thinking about relocating a bit. Why am I thinking about relocating a bit from this area? Because I think since those guys took one for the team, they are going to be so much more cautious for their surroundings and where they can peek and where they cannot peek, right? So, simply, fellas, I am simply relocating. Let's do this. What to do now? My main mission is going to be to support this E-50, because eventually the Super Conqueror should say, eh, and he should start making pressure towards our E-50, right? And that's exactly what we want to see, fellas. And this is exactly what we want to see. Meanwhile, our E-5 is saying, I love Arta. We cannot blame him, fellas. Arta is a beautiful part of the game, don't you think so? Beautiful. And now look, this is exactly position where I want to sit in, or sat at, however you are calling this. Wait. I am just simply waiting until they are going to get spotted when making a bit of pressure. I'm not too brave to reach this position here, because I'm kind of afraid if I'm a bit afraid if this 30B will try to proxy spot me. But now when E50 is dead, I believe we can actually get just tiny touch closer here, right? It's important. Beautiful Super Conqueror Schnei. He's not very, very happy. He lost 650 HP and now he's thinking, F my life. This is exactly what he is thinking, and in fact, he is pretty much dead meat. I don't really think he can do something about this, aiming for his track and rush. Unfortunately, we did not manage to punish him, but it's completely fine. We are spotting this guy, and our 430 is going to eliminate him from the game or not. Unfortunately, he missed. That's completely fine. It happens even for the best. And now, fellas, I want to show you the best magical thing ever. Skill, talk us through what is the best magical thing ever. This tank have 1100 alpha damage with a high explosives, and MX-30B is dead. Fellas, I had one hope. I had one hope to penetrate someone with high explosives in this video. That was only one hope which I had, and I can't do that. Big fat disappointment. Can we have a F in the YouTube chat, fellas? That would be very, very, very great. Fosh. Mine. Complicated. Although we can still hit him for for healthy number of HP, but it's it is not even close for the number which I was dreaming about. Anyways, what do you think about the small jump? Jump, fellas. Are you up for a jump? And unfortunately, I tried to shoot the Ruski tank and it did not work too well. And in the same time, unfortunately, but I lost my gunner. But you know what? It doesn't really matter because this guy is dead either way. He's trying to run from me, which is completely understandable. And probably he's going to try to dodge me as much as he can, but that's okay. We are trying to chase this mother trucker. He hit us once. He's still running away from us. And we are going to eliminate him from the game right now. I mean, game, you mother trucker, game. Okay, not much what I can do about this. Way too aggressively by us, right? But we still have like 2 HP left, so maybe we are going to get one more shot, or maybe not. That was such a bad play by me in the end. But you know what? I deserve this, fellas. I deserve this, and I need to give some kudos for that IS-32. He definitely outplayed me. He danced through the rock like a good stripper is dancing through the strip pool, and what can I say? He made my jaws to go open, and I simply couldn't think about the battle, fellas. I was just simply thinking about his moves, if you know what I mean, and yeah. So, 3 battles in row, Object 268. You tell me, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, is it still good tank nowadays or not? What is the pros, what is the cons about this tank? And once again, it is not that horrible in my opinion. It's not completely useless piece of crap as the Chinese tank destroyer is, in my opinion, right? So yeah, here we go. That's what we are having. 3,800 damage, 900 assisting damage. We are second by the damage. We are once again in the 7th place by the experience. But when you are playing with a tank destroyer, you can't expect to be first by experience anyways. And what we are having casual 4,100 damage session and 500 assisting damage, which is bringing us to 4,600 combined, which is okay. And looking into the average performance of this vehicle, fellas, I am playing with this tank quite well, right? So maybe I should be more kind or more polite towards this vehicle instead of saying that this tank is kind of out of the meta. No, it's not. You can still perform quite well, as you can see yourself. And you can hit your shots and so on. So, here we go, fellas. Thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill. I hope I gave some memories back to you. If back in the day, 6 years ago or 7 years ago, you used to rock and roll with a 7... with a 268, right? So yeah, thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill, and skill is out. Peace, fellas. Bye-bye.